So today I just have my hair up in a messy bun because it's rainy and crappy out yet again. Face is the Lancôme Nude Miracle La Mercier Pressed Minerals. NARS Laguna, I haven't used that in years. I thought it was close to the Glow Minerals, so I wanted to give it a shot. NARS Blush in Luster, I think. Eyes are, what is it? La Mercier Baroque. Easy Baked by Urban Decay. And a MAC, one of those prolonged wear shadows. I don't remember the name of it. Just in the outer crease under the eye. Mascara is that new Lancome one. I forget the name of it. It is pretty freaking cool. I really like it. Lips are Urban Decay Naked, regular Naked lip liner and lipstick. Shirt I have on from, it's a sweater from Ann Taylor. It's just a cute, comfy, lightweight one. Necklace was a current, the current custom used to sell these. I don't know if they still do. She does. Jeans are Paige denim and boots are Fry boots. Other than that, rings and earrings and other jewelry all stays the same pretty much. And that's it, getting ready to head out the door. So I am off to a doctor's appointment on Saturday morning, first thing in the morning. Not first thing, it's 10:15 right now. My appointment's at 10:45. When I get home, I'll put a clip in of what I'm wearing. But I put on this jacket because I always forget to tell you guys what kind of like jackets and things like I wear. This is a quilted like burgundy one. It has a nice hood. It's got like corduroy on the inside and like the hood has like a pattern to it. From Jack Wills. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of them. They're kind of like, we have a store at the Cape, but they're not around a whole lot, but a lot of people seem to know what they are. Rainy day here. That's why the hood is coming in helpful, so I can just throw it up. But let's see here. Today we got up and we all got up late and were exhausted from last night, which ended up being a bit of a party at our house for kids and adults after the trick-or-treating. And so it didn't last long because everybody got kind of bombed, but everybody had a good time. I don't drink. I don't know if I've ever told you guys that. That seems like something that's so common to me, but I don't think it's something that I say very often. I'm not a drinker, never have been. I was, even in college, I was the sober driver all the time. Just never been my thing. So I was, you know, good to go the whole time and everybody else was pretty feeling no pain, let's say. So we had a great time, but we're just all exhausted today. Tonight's daylight savings. Ugh, not looking forward to that. But we're going out with friends tonight to dinner, Saturday night. Saturday night's usually our like date night or out friend night, depending on who's around and what the week is. So we're gonna do that. But today I'm going to the doctor's, then we are going to my brother's fiance's little boy's birthday party, his 10th birthday party, and it's laser tag, so we're gonna go there, and it's not for long, and so we'll meet my mom there and hang out and play there for a while. Then we'll come home. I need to make a pasta bolognese. My favorite thing I make is a pasta bolognese sauce that I make from scratch, and it's from a recipe I saw one of those shows on the Food Network called The Best Thing I Ever Ate, but they did a Best Thing I Ever Made version, and one of the chefs made a pasta bolognese, and we tried it and made it, and it's awesome. It's a little labor intensive, but it's amazing. And I'm gonna make it today for dinner for all of us tomorrow night because it actually, we have learned over time, is better the second day. So even though we're going out tonight, I will make it today so that we will have it tomorrow night for dinner. So his mom and me and MJ and him will all eat dinner inside in tomorrow night since we've been eating, picking up food for the last couple nights, it feels like. So that's what we're gonna do. And tonight we will go out. So I will try and show you clips throughout the day of what we're doing. But right now I'm heading to the-
I love the way he's running.
He's getting up there pretty good. Yeah. You coming down?
He's gonna fly down.
Yeah. I'm ready to go out for a couple drinks and dinner with some friends. A little place by us that's got craft beer, wines, and artisan pizzas. And they look like they have some cool charcuterie plates and stuff like that. So we're gonna give it all a shot.
They're really good.
You got a picture, and I'm videotaping the muscles and the breasts.
I didn't get them.
You know it's bad when we've already eaten over half of them. Because they're so good. That one's a prosciutto and arugula, but then that was the burrata, which we have right here.
Yeah.
That one didn't last very long. Neither did the charcuterie plate. Anybody remember?
Portobello and shiitake.
Portobello and shiitake. That's it? There's gotta be. What kind
What's
of cheese?
The number one pizza that you guys, that people order?
The Duck Duck case. That's not my favorite, but Duck Duck case.
That's what Howard did.
What kind of cheese is on this? I was trying
this
to
has the tilapia.
So this was the duck pizza with the
egg. Oh, where's the egg? Oh, I see it. It's right there.
We already ate half of it.
All right. So this is the coolest bathroom I think I've ever been in. I absolutely love this picture, and I want it for my vanity room.
Can't even see the light bulbs. It has light bulbs all around it. There you go. They're coming into focus. How cool is that? I want that for my vanity room. How cool is that? And then I love these little ones. Look at these. The waitress said this is the coolest selfie bathroom. So if you're set a selfie, I would take a video and show you guys what the bathroom at this restaurant looks like. What color spoon? Green? Okay, hold on. We gotta wait and pay for it.
Pasta bolognese, day two.
Getting ready to reheat it. This is what it looks like after it has been heated back up and bubbling. Well, good morning. It is Monday morning. It is 8:30. I have already been out and been to the grocery store and to my P.O. box. I am now getting ready to head to the gym to do measurements from the last month. We do them usually around once a month, depending. I've had a horrible cold all weekend. It's been bad, but nothing you can do about it. It is what it is. Tried to tape as much as I could, but it was a crazy, crazy busy weekend between Halloween and the party and the people after, and then Saturday, I don't even remember. Oh, we had a birthday party, and sorry, I should turn the radio down. We had a birthday party, and then we went and hung out. Then we went out to dinner with friends, and then yesterday, we just honestly kind of hung around the house. We went to a yogurt place and I made a pasta bolognese, which I put some clips in, but I made it on Saturday because it's always better the day after. So now I am heading out to the gym today MJ has swim school and my mother-in-law leaves, I think her flight's at 3, so I think they'll leave the house like right when MJ goes down for a nap, so it'll work out good. And then the rest of the day is pretty much, oh, my cleaning lady's there today, so it's kind of maneuvering around her a little bit, but that's not a big deal. She's really good about moving around me, more so than me moving around her. So it worked out for the day. It is freezing here, 42 degrees. That's why I'm wearing a jacket. This is the Patagonia jacket that's similar to the vest I have. And it's amazing. It's so warm. It's crazy. So that's the day. We'll see what bits and pieces come of it, and we'll get the week started. So I am leaving the gym now, and we worked out, but we did my weights, my BMI, and regular measurements with the tape measure, and then the pinch measurements as well. And a normal person, I guess, in BMI, over the amount of time that we've, since the last one, loses like 1 to 1.5, and I've lost 3% of my BMI. And when we did inches, I lost like quite a few inches throughout different measurements. But the biggest thing was the pinch one, which gives a more accurate one. I'm down on my arms. Let me think about this. Arms were 8. Hips were, like hips and butt were 9. And my thighs were almost 11. It was like 10.5. So I am like super excited that this working out to the extreme that I've been working out and watching what I eat to the extreme that I'm watching what I eat is like really, really, really working. So super excited, wanted to update you guys and tell you about that, and I'm just so happy. I can't wait to get the actual numbers from her. Like, she emails me the actual numbers later. We went over them briefly right after she did it, but she'll email me the actual numbers and I can look at them all again and like really let them sink in later on today. But I am psyched that this is working out. Weight-wise, I only went down, 5 pounds? 5.5, I think, 5.5. It was something like that. So I'm just super excited that I don't care about the number on the scale. I care about the way the clothes fit and the way the clothes look and the way I see things should be looking. And I also am not one of those people that tends to look at others and go, I want to look like that person. I just want to look like what I think I should look like in my own head. And I think that's a better way for me to do this. So I'm super excited and wanted to share that with you guys.
Have you ever seen Brussels sprouts come on a stalk like this? This is how I buy my Brussels sprouts. They're actually sold as Brussels sprout stalks. And then I just pull them off the stalks and then I chop them all up into quarters or halves, depending, before I season them and cook them. We are making turkey tacos tonight. I brown up the meat and then I use some taco seasoning, and it says to mix it with water, but I usually mix it with part salsa and part taco sauce. And I feel like it makes it stick to the turkey a little bit better, because usually I use ground beef, but the turkey, to make it stick to the turkey, it seems to work better with those two. So I will make it and show you what it looks like. Also, I use the stand and stuff shells. I seem to like those the best. If you want a hard shell, I seem to like those. They're easier. We also use the reduced fat 4-cheese Mexican by Sargento, and usually a little bit of guacamole depending on what flavor I have. Right now I have the avocado ranch one. The best salsa, if you have a Safeway near you, is the Salsa Fresca in the hot one, the Signature Cafe. It is amazing. It is hot though, just so you know. And the salsa I'm using to mix into the tacos is just one from Don Pablo's that we picked up one night. All right, so the meat is all browned, and what I kind of do from here is first I shake in, I eyeball this on what a package would be, and it tells you, I think it's like 1/4 cup, and I mix this in, the taco seasoning first. So start mixing that in, so it kind of coats everything. Sorry, I think I moved the camera over to the side. And then I just kind of mix it all together, and then I let it sit on low for probably 5, maybe 10 minutes. Sometimes I take a look at it and go back, and I should probably turn the light on higher. There we go. Sometimes I go back in and add a little bit extra of salsa or of seasoning if I feel like it needs it. But I just kind of eyeball it. Or you can buy the seasoning package, which is the exact amount, and use whatever you want to, and at the water like it calls for. But I just find that this helps with turkey meat like stick to it a little bit better, and we love it. MJ loves it too, which makes me nervous because it's kind of spicy. So we'll see.
We're up and on our way to the gym in this Tuesday, and let's see here. Today I am taking Body Pump, which is a weights class. My seat is, oh, that's why it's on my husband's setting. I am taking Body Pump because, there we go. Because the class that I normally take, which is the Tabata on Tuesdays, is not going on today or canceled because the kids are off school, so they use our football field, the indoor football field, for things for the kids. They have like a camp that they can go to when school's out during the day. So there won't be any Tabata class on the field, so I'm going to take Body Pump today. And my cleaning lady is on the way to the house. It's 8:45. She usually gets there around 9. So I won't be taping much in the house today because she's cleaning the house. And so for the most part, I think today we may go to BJ's and maybe Target. Not sure. It kind of depends on how long we're gone and where she's at on the house when we get home. So she's really good about, we stay out of each other's way. She was supposed to be here yesterday, but she had an emergency dental surgery that she ended up having to do. Oh, can't even imagine that, that sucks. And had a reaction to like something they gave her. So she wasn't able to come tomorrow, which is fine, I don't care. We're easy with that. When she comes, she comes, she's awesome. So that's about it. And we're just heading to the gym and hope you guys have a great day and I'll catch up with you when I can. Oh my gosh. That house had Christmas stuff up. It's 3 days after, 4 days after Halloween, bless you, after Halloween, and they still had Halloween stuff up too. They had like leave pumpkin bags right next to the Santa and the Snoopy on a house. Who does that? I thought people do that after Thanksgiving. I'm ready for Thanksgiving, I'm not ready for Christmas. Oh my goodness, that just totally threw me off when I looked over. Ugh. So anyway, sorry. Catch up with you guys later. Just got done at the gym and MJ and I stopped over at my P.O. box and it is a beautiful day now. It is 67 degrees out already and it's only 10:15. So I think we're gonna go home and I think we may go to the P.A.R.K. He's eating some grapes and some juice in the back right now, so we might do that. But stopped at my P.O. box because I had to pay my bill, I had ordered, if you guys follow my hauls, I had ordered a eye palette and a bronzer from Glow Minerals from Premier Look, which is Brianna Stanko's, her online website. And I got the wrong eye palette, which was my fault. I placed the order for the wrong one, because this one's the metallic smoky eye kit, and the other one I ordered was just the smoky eye kit. So I got the metallic smoky eye kit in, today. Not sure why it went to my P.O. box, because they had my home address, but it was a lot of back and forth on email too. So picked that up, and, very, 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 very pretty. Truck sticking out there. Very pretty, very nice, neutral, wearable colors. Perfect for me. So I'm excited. I'll actually try and give that a shot today and show you guys that later on in the day. I just sat down and taped my very last part of my makeup graveyard series. You guys will probably have the end at the end of January, I guess. The last one that I did is my lipsticks. And I'm so excited. I feel like my whole vanity is clean now and I'm super excited about it. Cleaning lady is still here finishing up. MJ is napping and I'm just going to do some editing and I got to get some information from last week's vlog. And that's pretty much everything. Tonight we are having a London broil steak with Brussels sprouts that are roasted with, what did I do? Balsamic vinegar and something else. I don't know. So that'll be dinner tonight and I'll just show you some clips of that when I have a second. So we are not having the steak London broil for dinner tonight because I forgot to marinate it. I marinated the chicken breast, but not the steak. So I just put the steak in the marinade. The house is nice and clean. And so we are going to have the chicken breast tonight that have the Lupo's lemon and herb on it and the Brussels sprouts, because the Brussels sprouts just go in the oven and don't make a mess. And the chicken goes on the grill and doesn't make a mess. So that way my house stays clean and I'm not using my stovetop. So also I have on my eyelids that new Glam Glow Metallic Smoky Eye palette. I really like it. It's a really nice palette. I'm really impressed with it. I wish there was one matte shade in there, but I say that all the time. So that's what I have on and I really am enjoying it. Good morning all, it is Wednesday. Normally on Wednesdays I do go to a class, I forget what class, kick butt boxing or spin class. And yesterday I did body pump and I kinda tweaked my knee a little bit. So I think I'm gonna skip today. MJ does still have swim class at 11:30. We're back to 2 days a week for swim school. But I tweaked my knee and I really don't want to push it because tomorrow is step class and Friday is working out with my trainer and I prefer those 2 days. I am still in PJs. I have my PJs on with a sweatshirt over it just from
place that we go to at the Cape called the Chatham Squire. And then I have on those comfy PJ pants, the Jillian O'Malley. They are super, super soft and super comfy. So we are just maxing and relaxing for a while this morning, and then we'll go to swim school. Ate some turkey bacon, and now I am eating my egg whites with a little bit of sharp cheese, and I'm about a little bit more than halfway down on my first 33 ounces. So that is what I'm doing so far. Swim school is at 11:30, so we're just hanging out and playing. Hi, buddy. Say good morning. You're a good boy. Oh, you dance. Oh, you're Ninja Turtle. He's eating his turkey bacon, as you can see in his hand there. And we are checking out in the back there his snowsuit to see if it still fits him or if he needs a new one. That's on our list to do. And we are picking up a couple things from him. The reason we're trying that on is it's from Polo Ralph Lauren, and they have a 50% off their website right now. So we're gonna pick up a couple things, and if that doesn't fit him, we'll see if they have one on there too. So other than that, today, Marty has a dinner meeting, and and he has an HOA meeting, and I think that's it. So today might not be too exciting, but we'll see.
All right, so I totally forgot that today is Wednesday, and MJ has gymnastics class on Wednesdays. Totally forgot about that. Sorry, my camera's a little bit off. There we go. It is 4:30, and we are heading over to class, which is at 4:40, and it only takes like 5 minutes to get there. My knee is still bothering me a little bit. I haven't taken any Advil today. I probably should have, but I'm kind of debating on whether I'm gonna go to the gym tomorrow because I do a step class, and that could be hard on my knee. I don't know. I'll decide in the morning. So lipstick's pretty much worn off, but this was the Too Faced lip liner that I just got that'll be in a haul coming up. Or the haul already went up, actually. Forgot the name of it. And then I put the NARS Audacious lipstick in Anita on, and I love it. This is like, I put this on at like 1 o'clock, and I've eaten and drank stuff, and I love it. On my eyes is Stila in the Light Palette Liner MAC Black Track Mascara. Today I tried that, Laura Mercier, the full something one. It is super, super, super voluminous. If you like volume mascaras, that is voluminous mascara. The Lancome one is more about defining with some volume. This one's crazy volume. On my face, I have Marc Jacobs Genius Gel. I'm trying to use that up. Marc Jacobs Bronzer, NARS Blush in Madly, NARS Creamy Concealer Under Eyes, typical ones. Everything else is pretty much the same, but lips and eyes tend to be, and foundation tend to be my main changes. But I really love this lipstick. It's awesome. If you haven't picked one of them up in the VIB sale, pick it up. I also want the color Barbara, but they don't have it online right now, so I might stop in the store and pick it up just because I want to try it. These lipsticks are super smooth. So it's been a cloudy day, but it's 64 degrees out, so it's kind of nice. I have no idea why I have this jacket on. I have on one of those J. Crew baseball t-shirts, and it's got like 3/4 length sleeves, so I felt like I needed something on my sleeves. So we are heading to gymnastics, and then we are just hanging out, MJ and I, for the rest of the night, and I will see you guys later on, probably tomorrow.
Yet another dark, dreary day. However, I did just post on Instagram about this, and I'm gonna show you guys. I would like to replace the pillows on my couches with ones that are not from Pottery Barn and are not from Home Goods, because I have some from Home Goods that are like Ralph Lauren ones on the brown couch. I'll show you that. On the leather couch right here. The two on either side. I'd like those to be matching, but they are down feather. Go ahead, put it in the trash. They are down feather and they're uncomfortable. I like the middle pillow, but not the side pillows. And then on this couch, I would like to replace pretty much all of them. The only one I like is the striped one over here. It doesn't shed feathers. But because of this, I get feathers. Sorry, I'm in your way. I get feathers all over my living room. It's gross. They end up everywhere, and they're not comfortable to lay on, and so I do not like the Pottery Barn ones at all. Some of the ones at Home Goods are okay, but I have to find the right ones. Do you guys have any suggestions as to where to buy pillows for a couch, not for a bedroom, just like throw pillows for a couch
that aren't down feather. I don't know. Let me know if you have any thoughts.
So I'm pretty much finished all my errands, went and got my nails done. I got the color OPI Tickle My Francis. I gave her both of them and this is the one she chose. And I like it. I'm glad I did it because I can do the other color another time. Then let's see here. I went to Ulta and returned the brush and the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. I went by Pier 1 and I got two red pillows with a really pretty stitching on the edge, and you might be able to see the bag behind me, I'm not sure. And did that. Then I went to Target and got a new camera holder navigation thing right there, so it's gonna be a big bump. Oh, you might not have noticed it that much. But anyway, my old one was like not sticking to the windshield at all. It was like I come out every day and it was falling down and it was just a hassle and I didn't really like it. So I went, Miss Crystal here on YouTube told me about another one that she uses at Target and I went and picked that one up. It's from TomTom and I'm really, really liking that one so far because it is not moving off of the thing, which is really, really, really awesome. Now I'm heading into the supermarket and I am then going to go pick up salads and head home. So that's it, and I will see you guys tomorrow.
So today has already been fairly eventful. We ended up at my trainer's son and husband both got sick, so she canceled on me. Then she called me at 10:15, she was able, or 10 o'clock, and said she'd be able to train at 10:15. So we went to the gym later at 10:15, and then we came home. Marty took MJ to run a couple errands with him, and I got showered, dressed, and ready. MJ is napping now, and a toy that we got him came in, and it's huge. The box is like, it's like 4 or 5 feet tall. So I'll try and tape that when he opens it. If not, I'll show you guys later. Got a Sephora order in, getting ready to make the skinny buffalo dip, and wanted to tell you my results from the gym because we were talking about that the other day. Okay, so I guess I went down from, what was this? The BMI was 25.3, and I'm now 24.6. I went from 34.8% of fat to 29.2. So that's really, really awesome. Most of my chest, I went down from a 37.75 to 37. Biceps stayed the same, 11.5. Waist went from 30.75 to 30.5. My butt went from 41.75 to 40.75, a full inch off there. My thighs went from 24.75 to 24.25. And my calf went from 15 to 14.5. Then my on the pinch thing, I don't know if you guys know what the pinch is, but the pinch is like the most accurate way to do like your body measurements. On my tricep and my arm area, I went from 27 to 21, down 6. On my like waist, like butt area, I went from 27 to 20, 7 inches. And then on my thighs, I went from 41 to 29. That's 12 off. So I'm super, super excited about that. So I wanted to share that with you guys. Show you what I'm gonna put in for the buffalo dip in a minute. I will first show you my Sephora order that came in for VIB Rouge. Oops, I picked up the Glam Glow Kit set one, the Gift of Sexy with the big one or the blue one, a small white, a small black one. I picked up another NARS blush in, I don't even know how to say that. Nobody's gonna, there you go. It's kind of, I tried to open them ahead of time so I could show you guys, but it's still not working out. Do that in a minute. This one, it looks like, sorry. Oh, can't get it open. Come on. Doesn't look like much, but it kind of reminds me of Cargo Tanga. Interesting. I'll give that one a shot. I'm really loving NARS blushes right now. I have Madly on today. I got a sample size of the Formula X in this color. Don't know what color that is. A+. I would have put that on if I had that. Honestly, I might do that next time. Right now, I have on OPI Tickle My Francis. But another one of the Sephora Pro Tapered Crease Brush. This thing is the most amazing brush, 19. This is a must-have for everyone. Couple samples we'll take out. But another one of the Dior Buxom Lip Gloss. Somebody told me the color Amber.
was really awesome. Picked that up. Really, really, really pretty color. Still is not the color of my Dolly one, or no, Lola one that had been discontinued. Then I bought the Naked lip gloss in the color Naked because I love the lipstick and all of that. And this one actually looks more like the Lola than the other one. I'll try and put that one on in a minute. They had my Shiseido Sun Protection online. I've never noticed it on there before, so I picked it up in, it says medium ivory. Ooh, I might have gotten the wrong color. Darn it. And then they gave me the Sephora VIB bag. Ooh, what's this? What did I forget about? Oh yeah, the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick. I don't even remember what color I got in this. I think it was called, oh, here we go. Lolita. Ooh, really pretty color. So, that's it for that. I'm going to show you real quick making the buffalo dip. You use chicken breasts, blue cheese. Usually I use the low-fat one, but they didn't have it at the store. Wing sauce. Oh, gosh. I meant to get the third low-fat of this, too. Well, this is going to be way more fat than I thought in this one. And then just mozzarella cheese and yogurt, a cup of yogurt, just Greek plain yogurt. I don't have that out here. So mix all those together and heat them up. And I will show you guys. I'll post the recipe below. There's like exacts of the quantities, but this is the stuff that goes in it. I take the chicken and put it on my cutting board, and I use that same Pampered Chef chopper that I always use, and I simply just put it over some pieces. This is what I end up making it look like, just a bunch of little smaller chunks. You can also cut it up with a knife, and then I put it into the pot. So everything is measured out and sitting in here, and I'm just gonna start heating it up. Chicken's on the bottom, the yogurt, the cream cheese, the regular cheese, the blue cheese, and the hot sauce is on top. Half a cup of hot sauce. And I use that buffalo wing sauce. So we'll mix it up and I'll show you what it looks like. This is what it looks like when it's done. Nice and heated up.
What is that?
A tartar fowl. Nope.
You want to open it?
Nope. Fine.
You don't want to open it?
No.
TTT.
Is he cool, dude? MJ, is he cool? Is it cool?
Cool. Teeth.
Teeth. Yeah, teeth.
High five.
At Noodle Company. MJ had some mac and cheese, we had some pot stickers, Marty had a Japanese pan noodle, and I had a salad. So now we're gonna head to the yogurt place, and then I'm gonna go home for my mom's night out.
Well, once again, last night got away from me, and it is now Saturday morning, and I totally enjoyed myself so much last night that I totally forgot to stop and record what I was wearing or the whole bunko party. It was so much fun. Had a great time. Laughed. I got home around midnight and I was exhausted and went to bed. And I just totally didn't get a chance to do that. So I hope you guys had a great week and I'll see you guys next week. Oh, and I will be doing, I just did this eye look and I'm actually putting it on my vlog because a lot of people asked about what I had in my haul video, my Sephora friends and family, how I did my eyes. So I just put this on, it'll be coming up next week in the vlog if you're interested in seeing what it was.